preference forms for members to ministers, lectors, and altar servers without email can be picked up in the sacristy. Father Matt would like to invite all employees, volunteers, and their guests to attend an appreciation open house on Friday, March 1st, 2019, at Mary Memorial Parish Center from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Please come and enjoy hors d'oeuvres and fellowship. There are new ballots located in the back of the church this weekend for the voting of the new parish name. The name Blessed Trinity was disqualified because of another Christian church in the area of a similar name. In place of Blessed Trinity, you can choose Holy Spirit. If you already voted and you would like to change your choice, you can do so by indicating that you are abandoning your first submission. Ballots may be returned directly to the parish office or placed in the collection basket next weekend. Our celebrant for this Mass is Father Joseph McCaffrey, celebrating his deacon job. We celebrate the sixth Sunday in ordinary time. Scripture readings can be found on number 1109. In a special way of this Mass, please remember Ronaldo Genetti. Now please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, number 663, Lord of All Hopefulness.
Thank you. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and
ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed is the one who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord. He is like a barren bush in the desert that enjoys no change of season, but stands in a lava waste, a salt and empty earth. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside the waters that stretches out its roots to the stream. It fears not the heat when it comes. Its leaves stay green. In the year of the drought, it shows no distress, but still bears fruit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how can some among you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? If the dead are not raised, neither has Christ been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is in vain. You are still in your sins. Then those of you who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are the most pitiful of people of all. But now Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
During relates to what is happening. If you listen closely to the scripture tonight, as I said in the beginning, it's filled with hope, even in the midst of challenging situations. Consider this, that those who first heard the Beatitudes did not yet experience the resurrection. They did not know Christ was to rise from the dead, but they were going to experience his crucifixion. And he was offering that encouragement and hope, as he does to you and me. And sometimes we can be overcome with the bad news, with the difficulties, with the challenges of life. But Jesus turns the world upside down. And he says, when you are challenged, rejoice. And we can say, yeah, right. But in a way, it gives us an opportunity to show our faith in him, to trust in him. God's ways are not man's ways. So when we are persecuted, when we fall on hard times, as we have hard times in this community, we have to admit that. But that does not mean we are hopeless. It means we have an opportunity to show our faith in Christ and to keep him centered on what we are about. And later on, we're going to talk about all of us coming into one parish. What does that mean? Well, you heard the gospel last week. Jesus calling Peter and the disciples to be fishers of men. So what I'd like you just to understand, relate to the fact that the territory in which the fishing took place, the Sea of Galilee, is the idea of the parish. It's the territory that we have to work in. So right now we have seven separate territories, and all that's happening is they're going to be blended into one. Now, Peter had a boat. So did the other fishermen. The church building is often compared to as the bark of Peter, the ship of Peter. It's the tool by which you gather in the fish. It's needed for the work, like the nets. So if you think of these ships or the boats as the buildings and everything else you use to catch the fish, then you can think of the churches as that. Not church as the body of Christ, because that's who we all are. Church in terms of buildings and properties. That you will have to deal with later. After we are all one, then we'll have to prayerfully examine the situation we're in and say, what serves our needs best? That comes after we're all one. And we prayerfully consider what we have. And remember, we're all in this together. And if we keep our eyes focused on the Lord and what we are about, which is the past fading on to the next generation, we celebrate 200, 300 funerals between the seven parishes a year. That's almost a funeral day. How many baptisms do we celebrate? The ratio is 1 to 4. For every 4 funerals, there's 1 baptism. At least that's what it's been so long. Where's the blessing in that? The blessing is, well, we celebrate those funeral liturgies, we need to draw the living in by the witness of good people who have lived their lives and sacrificed for the name, and inspire our younger people to do the same. It gives us an opportunity to evangelize, to inspire, to encourage. You listen to these readings. Listen to the prayers of this Mass. And you realize that God has a message for all of us. Never to give up. To trust in Him. To always keep the main thing. The main thing. Followers of Jesus Christ are not quitters. They're not defeated. They don't give up. We follow one who has conquered sin and death. We are winners. We need to be excited about what does the Lord want us to do next? Generations before built all these parishes. When the community was growing and thriving, now it's our turn to do what we must do today. I believe one God,
Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ. The only God, Son of God, born of the Father, born of Jesus, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us and for our salvation, He came out of heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was born of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, He was crucified upon His side. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in glory to judge the living and dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is Lord and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Lord Jesus, you give us encouragement and hope. You plead with us to trust in you always, especially in times of difficult and challenging. Send your Holy Spirit into the hearts of all gathered here, that we may be trusted in you as we place before you our prayers and concerns.
This evening, please respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord.
For church leaders, may the Lord continue to guide and inspire them and keep them faithful to His gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all world leaders, may the Prince of Peace bless their efforts to put aside divisions and inspire peace and cooperation between nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick or lonely, may Christ's divine mercy bring them strength and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may God give us gratitude for those who teach and minister. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that have died, especially Ronaldo Genetti, may they find peace in the loving arms of Jesus for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now pause to add our
inside.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us not conclude by praying our marriage prayer.
Lord Jesus, who told us to prepare your hearts also, the parishes who once had to prepare for our faith in you, our children, and every person who gathers here. Help us to have the courage to sacrifice, to love, and to do in your name. Guide us by your spirit of wisdom, give success to the work of our hands, and keep us in your peace.
Rising from the dead, has given us the hope of everlasting life. And so
So we join the angels who sing today the song of your praise as we pray.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us from evil, and evil, graciously grant us peace in our day. But by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, I give you peace, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the name of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the risen Christ be with you all.
Amen. Peace be with you.
Let us all.
Thank you.
See you. Thank you.